Hello everyone, Ferb here, and welcome back to episode 3 of FTB Infinity Skyblock Hardcore Expert Mode thing. I'm not going to do all the random texts that I did last time because that took forever. Maybe I will, I don't know. Okay, what are we doing today? We are doing quite a bit of stuff actually. So if I take a look in my chest, I've already got stuff ready. We've got sand, and we've got bricks. So, what are we going to make with sand and bricks? Now, that is a good question. And that question will be answered very shortly. We're going to get ourselves some coke ovens. There we go. 24. How many do I need? I think 26. Yes. Okay. So, coke ovens. They are very important in this pack. Let's build it over here. For the simple reason that you need to have a coke oven in order to get your first bucket. And that is very important because we need to have a bucket in order to do stuff with Tinker's Construct, which we might also get into this episode. Okay, so we have a coke oven, and we need to throw coal into our coke oven. Where did all my coal go? If you may have noticed, I added some more barrels. I got an infested tree again. I have a whole lot of clay in here that I was getting when it was raining. I put a barrel here, which is now full. It can store 64 stacks of 64. Yeah, so that's light. Can I throw charcoal in there? I think I can, but it's not going to do as well as coal. No, I can't. Okay. I guess I need to find myself... Okay. I am going to get myself some more coal, and we already got some coal. Let's get one more piece. You know what, actually I'm going to throw this coal in right away, because I'm pretty sure the coke oven takes a while to work. So it's going to start burning up this coal, and it's going to convert it into coal coke and into creosote oil, which we need in order to get treated sticks. Which requires a bottle of creosote oil. So that's important. Okay, let's get some bottles going then. Do we have some more sand? Let's get some. Crap. Throw you in there. Okay. Split that. Go. Okay. Do. Okay, I'm gonna continue getting some more coal. Also, something else I forgot to mention, we now have 3 diamonds, 1 emerald, and yeah. So that's pretty cool. And we also got some more coal from that. Let's throw that into our coke oven. So we've got 500 millibuckets of creosote oil. I believe a bottle can hold 1,000 millibuckets. So we need at least 1,000 millibuckets in there, which is 2 pieces of coal. So let's keep going. We already have enough. But might as well keep going. Something else to note is that coal has a burn time of 1,600, whereas coke coal, or coal coke, has a burn time of 3,200. So it is double the amount of burn time as coal, which is good to note. So if you want to, I believe coal does 8 items, you can do 16 with coal coke then. So we have enough creosote oil now to get our first set of treated wood, which treated sticks we need. So treated sticks are used to make a forge hammer from Industrial Craft 2. In this pack, that's what they're used for. And you need the forge hammer in order to get iron plates, and you need iron plates in order to make your bucket. That's the only recipe for a bucket, so you need your iron plates. Okay. What are we at in terms? So yeah, we're good here. We should have some glass. There we go. And throw all of this extra stuff back here. I'll smelt it up later. Oh, okay. I guess creosote bottles can be filled up like that. Good to note. Okay, so we have one. Then we need some wood. Get 8 of that. Like that. Treated wood. There we go. Treated sticks. And then we need some iron. There it is. Forge hammer. There we go. And then 3 more iron. And we can get ourselves a bucket, guys. Finally. Okay. Iron plates. Oh, it's 2 iron. Well, okay. I guess I can spare some more iron. That is even more difficult than I thought it would be because we don't have a lot of iron at the moment. But okay, I will do it. Okay, so we have that now done. We've got our iron plates, and those can be finally converted into a bucket. Is this a helmet? Oh, did I... A bucket trophy. Okay. We have our bucket trophy. Let's place our bucket trophy down. We're about right on top of the crafting table. There we go. That's our bucket trophy right there. Okay. So we have our bucket. Can it be placed on your head? No, it cannot. Aw. I thought that would have been something they would have added because the achievement was, is this a helmet? Okay, anyway, we have a bucket, so we can now create an infinite water source, which is great. So that's something we, well, I've been wanting to do for a while because it's annoying always running out of water to make clay. So now we won't have to worry about it. If I have some blocks to make it out of. Okay, so this block has wood underneath it. And moment of truth. There we go. Okay. You can go back in the chest. And our bucket. And place our bucket. There we go. Okay, let's get more water. Bucket. Bucket water. And fill the rest of these up. And now we can make more clay. Okay. So there we go. We now have infinite water right there. So we no longer have to rely on the rain. That's the first thing we wanted to do. Or I wanted to do. Next up, let's get some smeltery stuff going. Smeltery. Where is our smeltery stuff? We're going to need some seared bricks, which require grout, which requires clay, gravel, and sand. We have a lot of sand. We have a lot of clay. We have some gravel, so we can start making this right away. Let's use a piece of coal coke to cook this to be efficient, or sort of efficient, and then let's get some more gravel going. Okay, so, do eat some apples. Okay, we're running low on apples. We need a better food source. I don't know what, do I have any seeds? I have cactus seeds, those don't help me at all. Okay, what other sort of seeds can we get? We can do some crop stuff. We can get seeds from sifting dirt. We can get a lot of different seeds from sifting dirt, including melon seeds. Ew. Okay, let's sift some dirt. Come on, dirt, don't disappoint. Okay. I don't need stone. I already have a form of generation. We're good. We got sugar cane. That can be useful. We can do stuff with sugar cane. Where do we want to plant our sugarcane? Maybe like right here? I don't know. There's no real need to put it anywhere else. So, don't think that's what I wanted to do. Nope. Perfect. And sugarcane seeds. You can't plant them normally. How do you plant them? I don't know how to plant sugarcane seeds. I can't hoe sand. What can I do? I can get crop sticks. How do you make crop sticks? Oh, please don't be changed. Okay, guys, just regular sticks. I didn't want it to be treated sticks again. Okay. Regular sticks. So, crop sticks. Can I plant those on that? There I can. Okay. And sugarcane seeds. Come on! How do I plant my sugarcane seeds? No. About mutation mode? No. Do I need water, like, nearby, as in, like, right beside it? Because I can do that. I can do water. Okay, I do need water right nearby. No crop sticks. Okay, good to know. Good to know. So put one of those there. Didn't need to put it there, but okay. And then that there. And there we go. Okay. So we're set up there. You guys are done. Mostly. Okay, we got 63. That's good for now. Let's start with making the basic smeltery components. So we are going to need a controller. There we go. We got Mighty Smelting, which is a great book for reading if you don't know how this stuff works. So we got a controller, we need a drain. That's not a drain. We need a drain. There we go. Okay, so controller, drain. We need a faucet. We need a casting table. We need a seared tank, so we need a piece of glass. Good thing I have some. Okay, seared tank. Okay, I think those are the basic components. And then smeltery glass requires, it still requires 4 seared bricks. Okay, let's convert the rest into seared bricks. We got 7. That's okay, not enough to get started really, but good enough. Okay. Where do we want it? Well, I'll put it right here. No. Over here. In the corner, right here. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, right here. Okay. So I'm gonna start clearing away a bit of an area for our smeltery. Go, we got our base done. So let's place down some of these parts. Seared tank can go here. We can place our controller right here. A drain can go right here. Yeah, let's do that. And then we're gonna have to dig out the floor a bit and drop it down, which is fine. No big deal. Now that we have water, that's easy to do. Move that torch over there. Okay. In there. Okay, cool. What else do we need? That's actually not supposed to go there. It needs to be moved over one. So, let's actually replace part of that floor. There we go. Break this part. Because it doesn't deserve to live. Can go. Okay, and then like that. And like that. That. Don't. Nope. That. And then let's drop this down a bit. Okay, there we go. That's good. That can go there. That can go there. And I guess we're waiting for more bricks now. What are you guys at? 15 more, 14 more. We've got 30, which makes 7 more seared bricks, which, does that give us enough to finish? It does, there we go. Okay, we got a full smeltery. As you can see, it's lit up, it's working, with 9 spots for items. And now we just need some lava in our lava tank. And that is actually pretty easy to do, I think. I hope. Okay, what we need a crucible. Not a crucible, we need to make some porcelain clay, basically. I'm not really sure what I'm saying. I think 7. Yes, and we need to make an unfired crucible. Okay, this is what you have to do. Okay. So the unfired crucible then has to get fired in a furnace. Pretty simple stuff. Wait for it to finish. There we go. And then I think I can just place it over top of a torch, and it will be able to melt stone into lava. So let's try that. Where do I want this? Just right there. Cool. Okay. Okay, melting speed 1x, that's good, should be. We can speed it up by putting lava under there later, but for now, if we throw some, where's the cobblestone? If we throw some cobblestone in there, and we heat this up, we get up. There we go, so we're converting now from, solid cobblestone to liquid lava. As you can see, that fluid lava needs to get up to 1,000 millibuckets for to actually create lava that we can pick up at least. Okay guys, and something else we are going to need is a few tinker's things. So we're gonna need, here, we'll just do this over here. First, let's make ourselves, that's not what I want to do. Let's make some sticks. Let's make a little bit more wood. Okay, we're gonna go like that, and we're gonna go like that. Get a blank pattern. Blank patterns are needed, definitely. We're gonna need some more sticks. Let's do that. Okay, let's try that. Let's try that first. Okay, so first we're going to need a stencil table. Okay, there we go. We got a few things. We're also going to need a part builder. We need a crafting table. We're going to need a crafting station with that on top. There we go. We got a tool station. Throw those in. I'll throw books away. There we go. Sort that chest. There we go. Okay, let's throw these down somewhere. Probably just over here. We got a tool station, part builder, and stencil table. Which one's this? Tool station. I don't want you right there. Kinda. Well, I'll start. I'll move you off. Okay. Where do we want these? Maybe like right here. Okay, so I want the tool station here. I want a space, part builder, and then stencil table. Yeah. Okay. And then we can throw a... Well, we'll throw something else there later. For now, we're good. I threw some iron ore gravel in there just to show something. Okay, we have enough now. So let's grab our lava bucket and place it there. That's not what I wanted to do. Place our lava in here. Let's grab some cobblestone to cover that up. There we go. So now the melting speed is times 2 here, and I covered this in cobblestone so nothing burns. But now we should be able to get a second bucket of lava a lot quicker. So it's a good first time lava investment. Now, one of the good things about skyblocks is ores that would normally take a while of playing in Minecraft to actually find, you can get pretty easily. For example, gold, yellorium, lead. Some of those ores are farther down and they take longer to get to, but in skyblock maps, you can really get them really easily, and even some like rare things. We got a few diamonds, we've got some uranium ore, I think, somewhere. Do we have uranium? We might. Oh, we have platinum, which is shiny. We've got diamond dust and diamonds and emeralds. Emeralds could take a while to find. Yeah. So it's actually really easy to find, to get items like this. It's just the quantity of them is kind of low when you first start off. But we can automate stuff later, and then that's good. Okay, we've got another thing of lava. Let's throw that into our seared tank. And there we go. We can see that now our iron ore gravel is starting to heat up, and it's going to melt down here. What do we want to do? Actually, I don't want to heat those up yet. I want... Okay, let me look at my... actually, let's take a look here. So... Molten aluminum brass requires aluminum brass. Okay, you copper and aluminum. Oh, how much does one ingot give you? Okay, let me figure this out. One ingot of copper. Let's melt this down. Okay, that gave me. Okay, it doesn't tell me the mill bucket's worth. Oh, I guess I just gotta throw together stuff and see if it works. So it was that and aluminum. Let's throw aluminum in. See what happens. Okay, so we've got some aluminum brass. And we've got some extra copper. 3 nuggets worth. Okay. Let's pour some aluminum brass over top of this iron. And we're going to get a cast. Oh, did it? Did it consume our iron? Was it supposed to consume our iron? I don't think it was supposed to consume our iron. I would use copper if I knew it was going to consume it. Or like something else that I don't need. Iron? Okay. I'm not doing that next time. Well, I won't need to make any more ingot casts. Anyway, we got our ingot cast. Let's get... Okay, let's get that other aluminum brass poured out and get an ingot of it. Okay, there we go. We got an ingot. And the rest of these are nuggets. So I don't think there's any way we can get that out. No. Okay. So I guess we just have to remove that from the smeltery by means of removing it like this. And then breaking this. Okay, so there we go. So that's how you can double your ores in the smeltery, because each gravel or ore will give you 2 ingots like that. So we have an ingot cast, so we can make ingots when it comes out. And yeah, and everything looks good. We've still got fuel. That's going to go down pretty quickly, though, so we should probably get some more lava, which it's a good thing we now have, and we can just refill. You need a bit more cobblestone. I will just keep cobblestone on me, then. You can go in here. Okay, and now I guess we're just melting down more ores. And get ourselves some iron ingots. To replace the one that we lost. It served its country. It served its country proud. It was used to create a cast to create more ingots of mass destruction. The glowing red iron ingots. In terms of making items, what sort of things can we make? We can make a pickaxe, which isn't useful, because kind of don't need to mine anything, so that's out of the question. What about some axes? Effective on wood, dirt, and plants. What about you? Hatchet. Wooden leaves. Okay. And you were the... Okay, yeah. So maybe we should make ourselves a hatchet. We can do that. At some point. I don't know about right away. No, I don't want to do it right away. There we go. Okay, so now we have officially doubled all ores that we get. Which is pretty sweet. Okay. And we've got lava. We've got automatic lava. Sort of. Not automatic. I'm not going to say automatic. We have got lava stuff. Yeah. And how much iron do we have right now? 7. Cool. Now, I don't actually know what we're doing next. Probably buildcraft stuff, because we need a lot of buildcraft stuff. So we need power. Now, power, I think I was planning to go with... the furnace generator. No, not the furnace generator. Can't go with that yet because it requires redstone chipsets, which require an assembly table, which we need power for. So it brings us right back to that first problem. So I think I was planning to go with a survivalist generator, which is blocks of coal, two furnaces, a gear. How can I make a gear? How do I make a gear cast? I need a gear to make a gear cast. How am I gonna get how am I gonna get gear to do the gear cast? Actually, I know how to do that. I think I know how to do that. Okay. Do we have any wood? No. Okay, let's grow some trees. This is where we're going to need to get a few more of those pattern things. What are they called? Wait, where are my sticks? Did I not have any more sticks? I didn't have any more sticks. Okay. So it's gonna make 6. Doo-doo. It's gonna make 3 of them. Okay, blank patterns. So this is where the patterns are gonna come into play. I don't know why my achievements keep resetting, but I guess that's something that just happens with mods. So I'm gonna have to deal with it. We're going to need some flint. So let's grab some flint. And let's go to the part builder. And let's throw... Actually, no. Stencil table? What are some of these? Okay. Okay, no. I don't want to be here. I want to be here. No, I don't. Oh, what was it? Am I not able to get gears this way? Because I don't think I am. Okay, well, while I'm here, I'm going to get the axe head pattern, and what was the other one? Axe head and a handle. Is there a handle pattern? Tool rod. Is a tool rod a handle? Probably. Okay. Where'd it go? Where's my tool rod? There we go. Okay, we don't need the other blank pattern for now, so we'll just leave it. Okay, so I'm going to need some, actually I need to go back there, I screwed up. Okay, we're gonna make our first axe right now, and then I'll get stuff ready for the gears later. So we need to go to our part builder. We're going to throw our axe head pattern in, and we're going to throw a piece of flint in and get our axe head. A flint axe head, which is pretty crappy and not going to take us very far. And then, okay, can you bone meal sugarcane? I don't think you can. No. And there we go. No, no. I have to put water right beside it too. Really? There we go. And we're gonna throw that aluminum brass in there. And melt that down. And throw our axe head on that. And then, we're also gonna wanna go over to our part builder. We're gonna want to throw a piece of cobblestone in there along with a tool rod pattern and get a stone rod and a shard, but I don't want the shard, so I'm gonna just throw off the edge because it's pretty useless. Okay, we've got a stone tool rod, and our axe is going to be a stone tool rod and an iron ingot. And it's gonna upgrade itself automatically over time, which is pretty cool. So yeah. Okay, so we have now our cast for the tool head, for the axe head thing. So let's throw our iron in there. And now we have our axe head, and we're going to throw that in our hatchet. There we go. So we got our iron hatchet. We're going to name it the Ferb Hatchet. That's, yeah. I don't want to do it. The Ferb Hatchet 008.10. Okay, it's the Ferb Hatchet 008.10. There we go. That is our axe. So let's get it and finish. There we go. So we now have a new axe to replace our old axe, which I am throwing. No, I'm not going to throw off the cliff. I'll keep it. Just in case. You never know. Our new hatchet might not be all it's hyped up to be. Oh, it's definitely all it's hyped up to be. It is a great hatchet. Oh, it is a wonderful hatchet. The mining speed on this thing is actually pretty decent, which is pretty cool. Okay, I don't need you. Flint can go away, and I'm actually going to grab a chest, and I'm going to throw a pattern on top of that to get a pattern chest, and throw that in this other spot over here, and throw our ingot cast, no, not ingot cast, throw our axe head cast and our axe head pattern in there. Sweet. Okay guys, so we're gonna come back next episode and work on a few things. First thing we're gonna do is try and get ourselves a gear. I'm gonna figure out how to do that. And also off episode off camera, one's not technically a word saying thing, but it's still technically true. Okay, anyway, off camera I'm going to get some more extra ores and stuff so we can start working, getting a power system, getting build craft, and like beating the map and stuff. So yeah. Ferb7001 signing off. If you guys liked the video, make sure to leave a like. If you disliked it, dislike, you know, each to his own. If you really like the videos and you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Ferb7001 signing off. See you guys in the next video.